going through or not. Hello, this apparently we might be live. Oh, are we live on the multiple platforms? Live, live, live. Oh, oh, we might be live. We might be not live. Oh, I think YouTube's in the house. Hello, YouTube. Are you in the house? Well, you might be in the house. I don't know. You don't see me. Yeah, that's weird. It keeps doing this every time I go live recently. Fucking people on YouTube don't see me. Oh, YouTube. Oh, you can now. Hold on. Cheeky bastards. There we go. I think we are. Right, we're live on fucking YouTube. Are we live on the Book of Face? The Book of Face. Facebook, hello. Are we there? Facebook. I think I can see it. Oh, we are live on Facebook. Oh, are we live on fucking Twitch? We are live on Twitch, ladies and gentlemen. We are live. Hey! Hey! Bonjour, dickheads! Salut les Français! This episode will be a mixture of English and French. Ce sera en français et en anglais. Les sous-titres seront disponibles, je ne sais pas quand, parce que mon sous-titreur, je sais pas. Maxime Boutet, il est là, Maxime Boutet. Hey, Maxime Boutet, he's on the live. C'est mon sous-titreur, Maxime Boutet. Maxime, tell us when the subtitles of this show will be available in English or in French. And with that said, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome again after 2 weeks off to another episode of Paul Taylor's Happy Hour. La la la.
Happy Hour? I'm not fucking happy. I'm angry. I'm always fucking angry.
Oh, hello. Welcome to the show. Salut tout le monde. Hey, if you're new to Paul Taylor's Happy Hour, the concept is very simple. I drink a beer or another alcoholic beverage or non-alcoholic beverage with a friend of mine, a guest that comes to the studio. And we have fun for an hour with you guys online. So let's fucking do it. Let's bring on my guest. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage the wonderful Mr. Fred Eyangoh. There he is. Man. Hello, sir.
Hello.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Mate, it's an absolute pleasure to have you here. Welcome. Please say hello. Say hello to Fred.
Hello, everybody.
Oh, there he is. Hi, all. Hi, Fred. There you go. Krista Smith off of YouTube says hi, Fred.
Oh, yeah. Hi, Krista.
Right, Fred. Now, every guest, when I bring onto the show, I ask them a couple of days before what kind of drink they would like, alcoholic or non-alcoholic. Mm-hmm. You sprang a surprise for me. Yeah. We haven't had any of this yet on the show.
Yes.
It's cider.
It's ladies. Cider.
Cider.
Yeah.
So, what I have prepared for Fred, ladies and gentlemen, is a cider taste test. Mm-hmm. Because French cider from Bretagne is amazing. But I'm more of a fan of English cider, if I'm honest. And I spent an hour going around Paris trying to find some English cider.
Yeah, let's start immediately with a fight.
Exactly. So, Fred, why don't you introduce yourself to people that don't know who you are, and hey, I will people. Get taste test.
Which is most people. Hey, people. Bonsoir, dickheads. So my name is Fred Eyangoh, and I'm a comedian in Paris. I've been doing comedy for 7 years, approximately, and the COVID year counts, sadly. like, you can't take that off, the thing. Yeah, I do comedy. I'm from Cameroon. I've been living here for, like, 10, 11 years.
Look at that. Like, Caro said, hello, Fred, are you from Cameroon?
I am from Cameroon. Caro, the playlist maker.
Do Cameroon people look a certain way compared to Nigerian people or
it's my one introductory joke, so maybe she just, like, seen me somewhere. I don't know.
That's a good pitch.
Are you the one from the thing? I am from Cameroon. And am I your first African guest?
No. I've had a couple. Multiple. I've had... the very first one, I think, was Daniel Jacksman, who's also from Cameroon.
Yeah. Sure.
I had Serge Maturin.
Yeah.
Although, is he from Africa or is he from...
Haiti?
I think he's from Haiti. All right, fair enough. And then I've had three girls, three football players from Dijon. One of them is from Nigeria. The other two are American, but African American.
Oh, that's pretty cool. That's pretty cool. Okay, okay.
Yeah, that was like the full, like, that was the that was a good show. But no one watched it, but it's fine.
Go watch it after this one. But yeah. So who am I? Yeah, I'm just like some wandering soul in the world of comedy in Paris.
Some wandering soul.
Yeah, I mean, I'm doing English comedy in France. So I'm like, Do you know I'm a bit nuts.
You do French comedy though as well.
Yeah, as well. But I started in English.
You started in English.
In English in like open mic night in Paris.
Okay.
Then I integrated like the comedy scene proper, like, I don't know, like after 6 months or a year, like, you know.
Yeah.
Like my first like real comedy open mic, I think, was like 6 months after I started.
Okay.
Yeah. And I've been doing it ever since.
And it's been. And then you moved to the French side.
Yeah.
At some point.
I think I've like jumping in and out of it. Now I'm back in.
Okay.
You know, like, yeah,
I like it.
Yeah. So I'm doing the bilang thing. I mean, French is my first language.
French is your first language?
Yeah, my first language of comedy is English, but my actual first language is
so that's interesting. Français. Right. I will get to that. Yeah. Nick Jones says, get that cider down your necks before it gets warm. Correct. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen,
we start with the most important stuff.
We have a taste test. Three different types of ciders. Mm. Two that are French, one that is English.
Okay.
And we're going to taste them, and you're going to tell me which one you prefer.
Mm-hmm.
And depending on which one you prefer, I will give you a full couple of glasses of the one that you prefer.
All right.
So let's do number one first. There you go.
Number one.
Taste test number one.
Okay. Like, we're so serious about this.
I know. Go on. What are your thoughts?
Yeah. A bit random. I don't know. Like,
okay, you're not a fan.
I'm hoping this one a little better than this. Like with more, I don't know. Either like more sour or sweeter, but it's like it's kind of middle of the pack.
I don't know.
Better. It's not bad, but it's like
I don't know if it's gonna be. I don't know if we're gonna have better ones. I didn't do them in any specific order.
Yeah, no problem. I'm like,
all right,
I'm going for it.
Number two.
Okay.
This one here.
Number two.
Ready?
Right, yeah.
Number two.
Mm. Oh, I like this one.
You like that one?
Yeah.
Like I prefer fresher. That one.
Yeah.
I prefer that one to the first one.
Yeah, yeah. Like, more fruity, like... Yeah.
Okay, let's do number three.
All right, number three. Ooh. Tricky. It's also good. It's a very different style from two.
Yeah.
One is out. One is dead. Goodbye, one.
One is dead.
One.
Okay, one is out of the game. Which one's number one? Fuck number one.
Okay, number... Oh, God.
Yeah, I'm the same. I'm between number two and three. I have a preference.
I think...
But...
Ooh. I have a slight preference for number three because I like to go sour.
Mm-hmm.
Like, this one is... More like fruity, like, you know.
Yeah, number two is more fruity, number three is more sour.
Yeah.
So you prefer number three?
Mm-hmm.
You the man. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, I will reveal the bottles of these three.
What did I do?
Hold on.
Am I starting a, The English-French...
All right, so... We got three different ciders, ladies and gentlemen. We've got cider number one. I've never heard of it. It's not number one. It's not necessarily number one. But the first one I found is a médaille d'or. It won a gold medal in Paris 2020. It's called La Mer Poulard.
Do you know La Mer Poulard?
No.
It's like this institute, like this restaurant. They have like a famous omelette.
They have a famous omelette?
Yeah, in Mont-Saint-Michel.
And they're doing fucking ciders.
Yeah, as well. We're just like... like, why are you doing drinks? You're...
Okay, so Mont-Saint-Michel... Okay.
I swear they have a famous omelet.
They have a famous omelet.
Like, the recipe is secret.
Oh, shit.
But, like, we won't tell you how we beat the eggs. Like, that's what I mean.
Okay, so they've won the médaille d'or. You can't close your eyes, close your face, put your hand over your face, go. There you go, ladies and gentlemen. It's because it auto-focuses on our faces.
Mm.
So it won a gold medal. I was like, if it's won a gold medal, must be fucking amazing. The next one that I chose, which was another French one from Loïc Raison, which won the World Cider Awards Silver.
Wow.
So it won an award.
So it's the second one.
It's the second one, but I think Loïc Raison is like a bit of an... like a. It's like the McDonald's of... Not the McDonald's, but it's like a chain. It's, like they do...
It's you.
It's like the Heineken of... Maybe, I don't know.
Yeah, like I've seen it.
And ladies and gentlemen, number three is Friels.
That's the winner.
Friels, which is from Herefordshire, Herefordshire, in the UK. This is one of the World Cider Awards Best British Sparkling Gold. Yeah. Gold. They've all won awards.
Yeah.
And I went around Paris looking for this one. So,
Fred, winning the only award that matters.
Out of your guess, which one is which thing? So, which one's number one? Which one's number two? Which one's number three?
I would say one, two, three.
Okay, so you think this is
the one that was maybe
not like, great, that you didn't like?
Like very class, like too classic, like in a
too
in
classic.
A
so way. That for you is number one.
Yeah.
That for you is number two.
Number two, yeah.
And then number three, your preferred one is this one.
Yeah, I think because, like the color, like it's clearer, and I think I
yeah, you're cheating because you got the color. So number three, the winner is the English cider. Oh, fuck you, Brittany.
Sorry.
Oh.
Sorry, Brittany.
Hey, écoute, Bretagne, votre cidre, il est incroyable, mais la Grande-Bretagne, on fait du meilleur cidre, selon un Camerounais et un Anglais. Donc, ça fout.
Oui, oui, moi, j'ai aucune carte dans le game, tu sais.
Ouais.
J'ai été colonisé par les deux, donc moi...
c'est vrai, écoute. Alors, là où tu t'es trompé, c'est que le numéro 2, notre deuxième préféré, c'est le Loïc Raison.
OK.
Et celui qu'on n'aime pas, enfin, qu'on n'aime pas, c'est la Mère Poulard qui est le truc un peu plus standard.
Ouais. OK, OK.
So.
Je me suis dit, la marque standard fait le truc standard, mais pas du tout.
Il est où ton verre, là?
Ouais, il est là.
There you go.
And like, I'm still gonna drink these.
I'm still gonna drink them as well. Like, do you think I'm gonna throw away cider?
No, never.
Fuck that. Never. The only problem is we've got less of this than we have of the other ones. It doesn't matter, we'll finish all three. Let me put these back in
the
fridge.
Maybe let's keep this one. What do we do like Jesus at the wedding, like keeping the best wine for last?
You know what, I think you might be right. Wait, we've got another bottle of that though. So let's...
Oh, okay, then we're good, We're not like...
It's in the freezer though, so I better let it...
Ines says, we don't need your opinions. We know French cider is the best.
Is that what they're saying in the comments?
Yeah, they're going like...
Nick Jones, if you don't like the cider, cook with it.
Cook with it? I never cooked with cider. Cook with wine. Can you like a cider risotto or something?
Yeah, they got cider vinegar. Delphine Brière says, La Mère Poulard, c'est que du marketing. It's only marketing.
Yeah, I mean, it's working. It's here.
Hey, we didn't even cheers, did we?
Cheers.
Cheers, my
thanks
friend.
Thanks for having me, man.
Mate, thanks for being here. Appreciate it. Willem Courcy says, is it spill time? Hey, if I manage to not spill anything, I have a reputation for spilling stuff.
All right.
Look, Keith McMillan says, as a Brit, I prefer Breton cider.
So as a traitor, that's good to know. Where the galette, like...
This is a thing in France. Uh-huh. People... cider is associated with pancakes, crepes, les crêpes.
Like, restaurant breton. Like, that's the only... I mean... For most people, I actually buy cider. I mean, I suggested cider because I actually like cider.
Yeah.
It's not always easy to find like good cider like in the bar or pub. Like they always have like Magners.
No. So like, I was looking for Magners. Like I wanted to get Magners on the list because Magners is like...
It's a Loïc Raison. Like,
it is,
in a way. It's like when if you want like something a little bit different, it's like hard to find something else, you know. But like anytime I find like good cider, I go for it.
I literally went to three supermarkets, like big supermarkets. I went to Auchan, Franprix, Monoprix.
Yeah, nothing.
The local Alimentation Générale, fuck all, nothing. And so I had to go to Nicolas, like a 10-minute walk away. And I was like, I'm looking for like an English or an Irish cider. Yeah. He had nothing. And the guy was like, hold on, I've got a box of stuff that just arrived. I don't know what's in it. Let me open up the box. He opens it up and he's looking at the bottle, Friels. And I'm like, I hadn't heard of Friels. And he's like, I can't tell. I can't see where it's from. And then at some point he goes, Herefordshire. I'm like, oh, there we go. English cider.
I'm home.
Good work. Mm. Lawrence Gale says Swedish cider is pretty good. Have you ever tasted Swedish cider?
No, never. I guess
there's a brand called Copperberg.
Copperberg,
which is unbelievable. It's very sweet.
Where do I find it, though? If you have tips for finding good cider anywhere, like I'll take it, because I do like drinking cider. Mocking French people was not enough.
Mocking French people was not enough, Paul. Now we have a cider
I want
war.
To reignite the old wars. Enough of the nice things. You know what I mean? Like, when's the last time France played England, like, in football? Like, meaningfully? 2000?
France playing England in football meaningfully? I don't know, guys. Like, I was waiting for World Cup 2018 being England France in the final. It was close, but that's why I really wanted France to win, because Croatia beat us, and I was like, "Fuck, I want France to win."
Yeah, might as well. I think it's like you were 2004 with like that Zidane penalty or something like that.
Oh God,
I might be the only. I don't know.
Are you a big football fan?
Yeah.
What's been going on recently? Because I'm on TikTok quite a lot recently, because it's the only place where stuff gets fed to me, because I don't follow anyone on any social media. Mm-hmm. But TikTok, you don't need to follow anyone for it to be in your face.
It's for you.
Exactly. And so I'm seeing a lot of videos of like shit going down between Marseille and Paris, or like
they played yesterday.
They played yesterday, and it was like shit.
I think it was Neil something. I didn't follow.
There's like
whole drama.
Shit, like people throwing like bottles and stuff. Oh, like there was a video I saw of like policemen with shields because the like in front of the guy to Neymar who was taking the corner, because like
they were throwing things, and I've seen
like four or five different videos, and they look like different nights. Like, what the fuck is going on?
I mean, it's an old rivalry. I haven't followed like the latest things, but like it's kind of weird. Like I don't watch a lot of games anymore.
I never really did,
but I kind of follow, like, try to follow what's happening. Like, who's where, who's doing what, like, who's being paid millions.
That's everyone.
Games. Yeah.
Basically.
I mean, Messi coming to Paris was a big deal.
Like, yeah, that was a big deal.
Like I saw, like a giant graffiti portrait of the guy. Like, that part of my house. I was like, okay, so he's here. He's here for sure.
he's definitely
people,
coming.
Like, overnight, like, people are doing graffiti of the guy. It's really iconic.
Oh, hold on. Oh. Apparently... Yeah, the microphone is, people couldn't hear you anymore.
Drop level.
No, it's all right. It's back. It's just, it's very...
You're going to have to instruct that unprofessional.
Yeah, it's very touchy. Fred, I need to buy some new cables. I need to buy some new cables because the cable... you can touch this bit. Just don't touch the wired bit.
Turn Fred's mic.
Turn up Fred. It's all right. Fred is back. He's back.
Tell me I'm back, people.
Look, see if you're back.
Of course, you're back. I'm back, baby. I never left.
Ines Longwright, you're going to have to instruct Fred not to touch his mic. Don't fucking touch the mic, okay?
Thank you. Well, like, Fred... it's like a storm. Like, everybody like, don't touch it. Don't touch it, Fred. Don't touch it. Hey, Chris.
Yeah, exactly. So stand up. You do stand up.
Yeah, I do.
You started in English. You're doing it a bit of French. What was the thing? I was like, oh, we need to get back to it before we got the drinks down. It was a good topic of conversation. I've completely forgotten.
We need to get back to it.
No,
before football.
What was I talking about? Yeah, it was before we started drinking the cider. I'm like, hey, that's a good thing. We'll come back to it. Let's first drink the cider.
English and French. Was it English and French?
It was English and French.
Did you say hammer time?
people are saying technical Taylor. It's not my fault, but yeah, I'm back. I'm not doing the jingle. I have a jingle when things go wrong, but it's all right.
Talking about, me doing stand-up, me starting like open mic.
Yeah, here's a good question to get the ball rolling. Gio Trevi says, Fred speaks... I say that because we've met and she's Italian. Okay. I'm not just making fun of her straight away. But I'll make fun of her anyway. Fred speaks American English. How come? Tell us.
So...
Before we get to how that you're English.
Yeah.
You grew up learning French. How long have you been in France?
10 years. 11. 11 years. 11. So my background, in summary. So I was born in Cameroon. Lived there for 19 years. First language French, and then pretty much because French and English are both the national languages of, like, the official languages of Cameroon, like Canada, pretty much. We have English classes from a very young age. Like, I started doing, like, learning English when I was 4 or 5. Because, like, you know, grammar classes, vocabulary. Like, it's kind of basic, but it's still, like, enough, you know, because you do it over the years, and it gets more and more complicated as the years go. But it's from very, like, grammatical perspective. Like, you don't really speak... I never really spoke English out of school.
Right, you just speak it in class when you're supposed to.
Exactly. Like, I only had, like, the English class, like, you know, kind of, like, only having the French class. I didn't have geography in English or history in English.
Right, only English.
Everything was in French, but, like, as a second language. So I had a good background, like, because of that, and then I learned a bit more, like, taking classes, like, at British Council and other, like, similar institutions.
Over in Cameroon.
And then when I came for my studies here, I went to a business school, which was pretty international, and English was required. So I even, like, had to amp up, like, my level. And eventually I came here. And I came to the school and I forgot, I was...
You came over to France for the school?
Yeah, for the school, for my master's. And then I was part of like the international crowd where English was kind of like... Of course. As someone said very nicely recently to me, the lingua franca.
Lingua franca, yeah. And it's so like the common language. Yeah, I don't know, it's like a Latin term that I learned at university and I forgot what it means. I know it just means...
The common language, like people talk when they kind of agree to talk that language among themselves, like, you know, the language of choice. So for, ironically, ever since I've been in France, I've been speaking English a lot more because I've always kind of been in international crowds. Mm-hmm. And even more when I started doing English comedy.
Yeah.
You know, where it's like, you know, like you go to nights where the audience is like Anglophone and like the people on stage are speaking English. So, you know, like it's just like it became like kind of my main language in a weird way.
Yeah.
And for the accent, it's just, you know, like kind of like the cultural influences. Like I the first thing I watched were like Mad Men and Jon Stewart, The Daily Show, you know, like subtitled in Cameroon, which was like so, it was so fun, but it also like, you know, you start like, you just absorb the way people pronounce things. And that's how we start. Like the more I talk, the more you can tell I'm not American. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah,
you'll notice like words like, oh, this is strange. What is that? What's that? You know, but like in general, it's because like, you know, watching like American TV shows with subtitles to like learn, not to learn as early, but like that's also how you improve your French, your English. That's what I did for mine. And then again, even when I was like in the international crowds, the dominating accent was the American one. You know, like German people kind of speak.
Yeah, no, like, the Brit, like people, I find that people only have like English accents. Foreign people only have English accents if they've been, for some reason, if they've lived in the UK or they've been really exposed to like a UK style of learning or their teacher was English or something like that. The funnest times is when my little girl is in creche and the first creche that she was at, there was a French woman that was looking after her and she was like the English speaker of the, like she would speak in English to all of the kids.
Oh.
But she had like a French-Irish accent because she spent like a couple of years in Dublin. I think it was Dublin. It was somewhere in Ireland and it was crazy to hear like a French, it was like you could tell she was French, but she had an Irish twang.
Yeah.
And I love that stuff.
Yeah. It's just a mix up like origins and like influences and just like creates this weird melting pot of like, where are you from? Like the most common thing I get is your American, and also like some Americans have been like, okay, you're American, but we don't know where from because I don't have a very like,
you could be from New Orleans. Like where they've got a very French influence in New Orleans. Like,
okay. But it's, I don't know. Maybe. But like,
you sound more American than anything else when you're speaking. Yeah, if you're wondering why we're speaking English, ladies and gentlemen, it's because Fred and I, at most of our interactions ever, have always been in English because we've met each other and seen each other on a lot of English comedy nights here in Paris.
Yeah.
And so we've only spoken to each other in French like a couple of times.
Yeah.
In French comedy nights where you've done a couple and we like... we've crossed paths in French, but that's, if you're wondering like why, if his first language is French, Paul, why are you speaking to him in French, in English? Yeah. That's why.
That's why. Yeah. It's kind of, you meet in a certain circle and then it kind of sticks, you know, even if you speak the other language, it's a weird habit. Like, on peut changer en français si tu veux, mais tu vois, il y a un truc de, c'est un choix conscient de changer en français en fait.
Ouais.
Parce que quand je suis arrivé, on s'est parlé en anglais immédiatement.
Oui, la première chose qu'on s'est dit, c'était en anglais. Et puis là, du
même
coup,
quand on s'envoie des textos, c'est en anglais.
Ouais, mais parce qu'on a l'habitude de se voir en anglais, donc du coup, c'est assez étrange. Même si on parle tous les deux bien français.
Ouais.
Enfin, on parle tous les deux bien français. C'est le mec qui fait comme t'es un étranger, ton niveau de français, il est correct quand même.
Il est pas mal, hein. Il est pas mal. Il est pas mal en plus.
Mais ce qui est cool, en fait, je parce que moi, je connais. Alors, je connais toi, je connais Donnell.
Jaxman.
Ouais, et je sais pas, il y a forcément d'autres humoristes et d'autres gens que j'ai croisés qui viennent du Cameroun, mais je trouve que...
Donnell, il est né au Cameroun?
Ouais.
Ok.
Je sais pas quelle heure, mais je crois qu'il est venu en France plus tôt.
Oui.
Mais le truc, c'est que ce que j'ai remarqué, c'est que... en tout cas, les gens avec qui j'ai eu l'interaction, il y a pas un accent...
Au Cameroun,
bah, y a pas un accent... on dirait un accent français, en fait. Pour moi, en tant qu'étranger, j'entends un accent français. Contrairement à genre les gens de l'Afrique du Nord, Maghreb, le Maroc,
même un peu
Tunisie.
L'Afrique de l'Ouest aussi parfois.
Hein?
Même parfois un peu l'Afrique de l'Ouest aussi, je pense.
Ouais.
Je sais pas, c'est peut-être que les accents déjà à la base sont un peu plus proches ou un peu moins, pas forcément marqués, mais j'ai jamais pensé comme ça, mais en fait, il se trouve que peut-être la façon dont. Parce que. Il y a un truc où, en fait, la façon dont je parle maintenant, c'est pas exactement la façon dont je parlais si j'étais au Cameroun.
Ouais, c'est parce que là, ça fait 10 ans que t'es à Paris, donc t'as...
Exactement, mais tu vois, si ma mère m'appelle là tout de suite, même juste en pensant à ma mère, déjà, je parle différemment. Tu vois, enfin... Quand je dis maman, c'est plus le même accent, déjà. Ouais.
C'est quoi l'accent genre, et si tu imites ta maman qui parle, qui t'appelle au téléphone, c'est quoi l'accent typiquement camerounais, alors, si on doit...
Moi, j'ai... En général, je décris l'accent camerounais comme par rapport à l'accent français comme étant un peu plus plat. Par exemple, alors, je vais faire la même phrase deux fois. Par exemple, quand je parle comme ça, tu as l'impression qu'il y a des mouvements un peu plus genre vers le haut, vers le bas, qui
En français. De France, OK.
Ouais. Alors que quand je parle comme si j'étais au Cameroun, c'est beaucoup plus plat.
Oh shit, moi j'ai du mal.
Il y a un peu moins de mouvements dans le haut, le bas, etc. Le haut, le bas. Le haut, le bas, le haut, le bas.
Ok.
Tu vois, je trouve que c'est un peu plus. Ouais, il y a un peu moins d'amplitude, je dirais.
Ok.
Je sais quand je suis au Cameroun et que je tu vois, quand je parle.
T'as forcément des phrases ou des expressions ou des trucs que tu vas dire quand tu parles à ta mère que
oui,
tu
ne
dirais pas
sûr.
À Paris.
Ah, bien sûr. Mais ça, tu vois, là, c'est un truc où mon cerveau s'est adapté, tu vois. Donc, c'est pas forcément, je sois toujours très conscient. Mais je sais que je peux changer un peu en fonction de la personne avec qui je parle. Et puis aussi, la façon dont la personne te parle influence aussi la façon dont toi, tu réponds, en fait.
Okay.
Et le fait que toi, par exemple, tu me parles avec un certain accent,
ouais.
Ça me... Enfin, je sais pas si ça me force,
ouais,
mais en fait,
ça
m'entraîne
je comprends.
À parler d'une certaine façon.
Mais moi, j'ai la même chose. Un de mes meilleurs potes, Rolly, mm-hmm. Rolly Assal, je ne sais pas mm-hmm. si vous êtes rencontrés.
Non, jamais, mais je l'ai vu sur...
Il est québécois. Et donc, forcément, quand lui, il est là avec moi, bah, moi, je prends plus l'accent québécois quand il est là parce que...
Et pareil, moi quand je vais dans le sud, tu me laisses deux jours dans le sud, je commence à faire...
Oh putain.
Je commence à faire un truc un peu étrange, tu vois. Mais N, il devient un peu plus long tout d'un coup, comme ça. Mais tu vois, mais c'est parce que...
Plus lentement.
Après, je sais pas si... Exactement, tu vois. Mais en fait, je sais pas si... Parfois, je me dis, est-ce qu'il y a des gens qui... C'est un truc de langue, mais je me connais pas du tout en genre science du cerveau par rapport aux langues. Mais est-ce qu'il y a des gens qui ont plus ou moins de facilité, enfin une facilité, mais de automatiquement, tu vois, qui changent, d'autres qui changent pas.
Ouais, oui.
Tu vois.
Mais je crois que c'est quand tu grandis avec plusieurs langues, tu as plus de facilité peut-être à t'adapter.
Peut-être. Peut-être. Oui, peut-être aussi le fait
d'avoir. Quand un français, typiquement, quand il parle dans les pays anglophones, mm-hmm. on a tous le truc de Hello, my name is Jean-Pierre, very good.
Exactement. Mais tu le sais.
Ils font zéro effort, mais juste parce qu'ils ont pas d'autres.
Est-ce que c'est un effort ou en fait, est-ce qu'ils ont. Comme tu dis, moi, j'ai quand même un peu parlé anglais et tu vois, et j'ai été ma mère a beaucoup voyagé, tu vois, donc j'ai rencontré des Français quand j'étais très jeune et tout. Enfin, même au niveau de l'oreille, j'ai un peu l'habitude.
Mm.
Et après, enfin, quoi que tu as la télé française au Cameroun, donc peut-être c'est pas vraiment un impact. Mais en termes de langue, peut-être des gens qui ont plus ou moins de facilité avec ça ou qui changent plus ou moins, je sais pas, tu vois. Parce que moi, j'ai l'impression que tu mets dans un endroit vraiment genre 2-3 jours. Et mon accent change assez
ouais,
vite.
Ouais, ouais, ouais. Bah, il y a des gens que ça arrive et des gens...
Ouais, je sais pas. Tu vois, mais même genre, juste en termes de... je parle pas espagnol ou italien ou quoi que ce soit, mais généralement, en termes de prononciation, je suis pas mal.
Oui, je comprends.
Tu vois, même en allemand, tu vois, enfin, j'ai fait quelques coups là, mais tu vois, j'arrive assez facilement à prononcer des trucs, tu vois, genre, je sais pas... les trucs comme ça, enfin des sons un peu particuliers.
Est-ce qu'on ferait pas un test? Est-ce qu'on demanderait pas aux gens de nous écrire des mots allemands?
Oui, allez-y.
Une phrase allemande.
Envoyez des mots en allemand pour voir si.
Let's do it. Let's test Fred's ability to do different accents. I'll try it myself. Give us phrases in Spanish, in Italian, and in German.
Je donne un exemple qui m'est arrivé aujourd'hui au déjeuner parce que j'étais à un resto qui s'appelle Boca Mexa,
ouais.
Qui est un restaurant mexicain. Et c'est juste l'idée de, tu vois, un burrito.
Ouais.
Burrito.
Yeah.
Burrito.
Yeah.
Tu vois, le truc de juste, t'as un mot, mais en fait, la façon dont les gens le prononcent. Et en fait, je pense que j'étais avec ma copine américaine, du coup, burrito.
Can I get a burrito?
Can I get a burrito? Je vais en mettre un. Comment?
Il y avait une française derrière moi. Can I get a burrito?
Exactement. Il y a aussi ça. C'est ça, il y a un truc.
Tu passes pour un con.
Exactement. Moi, elle arrive, je commence à faire genre, ah, guacamole. Et tout d'un coup, je me dis, non, fais pas ça.
Guacamole.
Ouais.
Mais c'est comme moi, quand je rentre en Angleterre, je vais au prêt-à-manger. Tu sais, la chaîne.
Prêt-à-manger.
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 Prêt-à-manger. Et moi, je rentre et je dis, can I get a croissant, please? Or can I get a pain au chocolat and I'll get a... Parce que si je dis, can I get a pain au chocolat? It just, you sound like a dick.
Yeah, you do.
Right, so phrases in Italian, in Spanish or in German, go in the comments right now. While we wait for those, Fred, are you performing in Paris soon or even now? What's, hey, is that a photo of me and Tristan Loiseau? I guess it is. I'm trying to see where
is that you on the right?
It is me on the right. Yeah, I don't know where that is though. I'm wearing a shirt, so it probably is at one of my shows. Anyway, are you performing in Paris soon or any?
Yeah, I'm performing tomorrow.
Tomorrow, so for the people watching today.
Yeah, if you're watching today, I'm performing tomorrow at two shows actually. One is called Laugh Etc. It's at the
Laugh Etc.
Don Camillo. Don Camillo at like Rue des Saint-Pères. And the other one is at Blast Off Comedy, hosted by Terrence Wong. It's at the Kibele, which is like in the 10th.
Okay,
like
Kibele,
next to Le Kibele, La Bonne Nouvelle.
So is this shit on your Instagram or somewhere? Can you announce your show? Oh, it is on your Instagram.
Yeah, I'm trying to do it now.
Go follow while we wait for the comments in the different languages.
Yeah. My Instagram is Fred Me Up. It's like Fred Me Up.
Yeah, that's easier to find, I guess. Let me get your Instagram up. There
oh,
we go.
That's nice. Yeah,
there
exactly.
We go. So go follow Fred on Instagram now.
I'm just gonna not warn people and just tell them like if you don't see anything comedic on that page, it's normal because I don't give a shit. I do whatever the fuck I want. But also,
Fred is at 501 followers. Let's get him to 600 right now.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah, let's do it.
Are you flexing?
Get him to 600. We should do it. So go follow Fred on Instagram for his dates on his shows, and let's go down to see the phrases that are in different languages. Okay, here we go. Right, Xavier Thibault. This is German one. Go on.
Ich bin ein Schnabeltier. Oh, ich bin ein Schnabeltier.
Yeah, that's exactly how I would have said it.
Aufenthaltsgenehmigung.
Aufenthaltsgenehmigung. Where are you reading this? This one. Emily Coulon.
Aufenthaltsgenehmigung.
It sounds.
Rolf, willst du mit mir Tennis spielen? Spielen, like a spa.
Rolf, und the Germans. My German accent is horrific.
Wie geht's, Leute? Ich hoffe, ihr habt viel Spaß heute. Abend. Heute Abend.
Heute Abend. I've heard that. Heute Abend.
Like tonight, right? I hope we have a lot of fun tonight.
Oh, okay.
Hello, everybody. No, how's it going, everybody?
Jesus.
I hope we have a lot of fun tonight.
There you go. In Spanish, from Boris.
Oh, la tenemos bien chingón. Pero bien perón. What does it mean?
Yeah, that's good. La tenemos bien chingón. Chingón is a Latin American phrase rather than Spanish from Spain. I think it just means like mate. Yeah. It's like, la tenemos bien chingón, pero bien perrón.
Perrón.
I don't know what perrón is. Again, that's like Latin American slang. I don't know. I think it just means we're having a good time.
Like, look at Frederick Day. That's like from his like German class.
Anna sucht eine Zimmer in Fribourg. Das Zimmer ist nicht
frei.
Frei?
I feel like...
It feels like it's missing something.
Anna sucht ein Zimmer in Fribourg.
Here you go. Here's some Italian for you from Michele.
La birra italiana è buona come la cucina inglese.
It's a good joke.
Yeah, it's a good joke.
La birra italiana è buona come... I don't know why I'm doing the hands. Stop doing the hands, Paul. Hands behind the back.
I'm going to be extremely racist in 2 years. Right?
La birra italiana è buona come la cucina inglese. Va bene, tutto bene. Non parlo italiano.
Good. I got a good. I have a good from Linda Wonder Woman.
Where's Linda Wonderman? Good. Yeah, but she's French, so I don't trust her. Could you pronounce that? Here we go. Senya Shevchuk, she's from Russia.
Ooh. Privyet.
Privyet.
I don't know. Povoyo? I don't know. Po-Ruski? I think she's asking me.
If we speak Russian. Ruski is the last word. Privyet is the first word. Privyet. Yeah. All I know in Russian is Privyet, меня зовут Пол.
Me...
Меня зовут
Фред. Меня зовут Фред. Привет, меня зовут Фред.
Or здравствуйте, which is hello in a more formal way. I think здравствуйте, меня зовут Пол.
I don't know.
Как дела?
I know mir means
here, here we go. Here's a proper linguistics definition from Emanuela. In linguistics, accommodation is the process by which participants in a conversation adjust their accent, diction, or other aspects of language according to the speech style of the other participant. Accommodation. There we go.
There's also a concept called code switching. I think it's...
Code switching.
Which is also about, like, you know...
I studied linguistics in uni, and I've forgotten all of this shit because I was too busy insulting French people. Fuck me. Are we done there?
Oh, damn.
Oh, Jesus.
Okay, parfois, but you know, I'm terrible at accents, though. Like, if I try to make a specific accent, like in English or anything, like, because, or in French, like, there's, parfois, puis en crisla.
But like, he's from Quebec. Maxime does my subtitles.
When are they coming, the subtitles, by the way?
Yeah, he didn't answer. Maybe he did, but there's too many comments. So, Bridget Leonard, I just finished my linguistics test, so I can join the live now. Yeah.
Oh.
Aigle de la route, il dit effectivement les sous-titres vont être fun à faire.
That's gonna be something.
Bro, Maxime is a fucking legend with the subtitles. Yeah. He has another real job. What I need to do, Max.
I told you. That's why Frédéric Day. Like, that's what I remember from my German class. I told you.
Oh, that's all he remembers from his German class.
It's a typical, like, she's looking for a room. Like, yeah. That's
where is the monkey? The monkey is under the table.
Exactly. So, yeah, that's kind of, like, my language path. Like, languages are fun. Like, I never really, like, learn anything else specifically, but I have, like, bits of German and Spanish and, like, just, like, you know, kind of, like, you get from the atmosphere, from the matrix. You just, like, pick up a little bit of the rest.
What else have we got? What questions have you got for Fred?
What's express yourself? Which
Oh, express yourself. Will we do an express yourself with expressions from... Okay. Okay. So I have a segment on the show called Express Yourself. Usually, I ask the audience to share their favorite expressions in the opposite language of the guest.
Okay.
So if they're mainly a French speaker, we get English expressions and we find out if they know what it means. Okay. We have a lot of fun with them.
Okay.
If they're... whatever. This is a great idea, Misha, is to do an express yourself, but you give us a Cameroon expression.
A
Cameroon expression? How do you say it? Cameroonian. I was going to be like a Camerounais. J'avais en français, mais in English, I didn't have a Cameroonian expression in French that we all have to guess. Does that sound good?
Ooh, wait.
I'm going to do the jingle.
Giving me homework?
I'm giving you homework. But we're going to do the jingle. Ladies and gentlemen, it is time for Express. Send me your favorite expressions in English or in French and we'll see if my guest understands them. Do you need more cider? I think you probably do.
Oh, certainly. Hit me up.
What one are we doing? Let me get a real glass. Have you finished all of them?
Yeah. No, I have not.
Let me get you. Which one do we want to go with the worst one, or do we want to go with the second best one?
Second best.
That's what I thought. Keep thinking about that expression, my son.
Okay. I'm also thinking of like just kind of like slang rather than
if you were speaking to your mum and you
you
had a specific phrase that
no,
you were
not
like
my mum bad example because it's always, all right, it's always a bit formal
a good friend like a of friend, yours yeah. A good friend of yours in Cameroon if you were like hey ce soir blah 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 insert Cameroonian expression have you got one. Damn. Okay, maybe this wasn't
okay. I have one simple one. I'm just gonna throw it out. Here.
Okay. I'm gonna hold on. I need to type it in. Oh, can't I type it in the comments anymore? Why can't? Oh, wait. Hold on. I used to be able to type a comment myself.
I can't
do it anymore. They've updated it. Fuck pricks. Okay, I'm gonna have to add some text here. Right, you're gonna go on. You type it out.
Okay.
You type it out in the thing there. And then and I'll put it up on the screen, and then we will all try and guess.
Oh, wait.
Is that it?
Uh-huh.
Okay, I like this, because I have no idea what it is. All right, let's go. On se tcha.
On se tcha.
Also cha. So you say also cha.
Also cha.
Well, it goes. So it goes down. Also cha.
Also cha.
Cheers, by the way.
Cheers.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, from the chat, what do you think that also cha means? It means, all right, so it's clearly you're doing something with someone else.
You what?
You're doing something with someone else, like on se parle, on se capte, on se chat, on se moque, gonna go with
this. On se capte.
Huh?
On se capte.
On se capte?
Yeah, on se capte.
Oh, on se capte, which is like we're like hey, let's meet up sometime soon.
Mais c'est intéressant, je pense, parce que chat à la base c'est je chat.
Ouais. Shall we have some tea? That's exactly what it is. That's the British version of on se capte.
Like,
shall we have some tea?
will we have chai?
We're going to chat. See you soon. On se voit plus
on
tard.
On se voit plus tard.
On se capte.
C'est quelque chose que tu dis quand genre à la fin d'une conversation, à la fin genre genre on se voit plus tard. Tu vois?
Ok, on se voit plus tard. Genre on est au téléphone.
Ouais. Mais en fait,
hey Fred, ouais, c'était trop cool. On se chat.
Mais si tu dis je tchat quelque chose, c'est je prends quelque chose.
Ah, je tchat quelque chose.
Ouais. Est-ce que tu as tchat le way?
Ok. Ouais, attends, il faut que tu l'écrives. Attends. Parce que ça, c'est une autre bonne expression. Ouais. Parce que j'aime bien ça. Attends, t'as deux verres. Pardon.
Attends.
Je te fais.
Est-ce que. C'est une chose que j'ai jamais à écrire, donc il faut m'excuser.
Ah oui,
s'il y a des Camerounais ici, moi je suis pas pro de la.
Est-ce que tu as. Attends, ouais, non, c'est parce que mon clavier est en couverture.
Je sais.
Je suis désolé, j'ai un clavier normal.
Tu as le way. Comment tu fais les accents ici? Bon, on va faire le.
Le way à Y.
Non, je crois que c'est plutôt genre comme ça, genre le way.
Ok.
Bon, le way.
Ok.
Ouais.
Est-ce que t'as tcha le way? Moi j'adore. Est-ce que
t'as tcha le way?
Est-ce que t'as tcha le way?
Mm-hmm. Est-ce que tu as tcha le way? Le way c'est genre la chose. The thing. Like,
You gotta let them guess first.
Sure, I will give.
But now you've given it away.
I'm sorry.
It's all right. Est-ce que t'as tcha le way? Is it like, did you mm-hmm. take the thing?
Exactly.
Did you take the
but
thing?
But chat is really like taking something. I have other ones. Don't worry. Passe-moi le sel.
Passe-moi le sel. Constance.
That's my roommate.
Is that your roommate?
My roommate.
Is it? It's your roommate. Hello. Hi, Constance.
Hey, Constance.
Wait, when you say
on
roommate.
On se voit tout à l'heure. Uh-huh.
On se chat.
On se chat. On se chat.
Was that the right context?
It's pretty good.
Okay.
Very good, yeah.
Also chat. Mm-hmm. Hi, Constance. When you say roommate, you mean flatmate. You're sharing
flatmate.
A flat.
Yeah, yeah.
I never understood that in America.
Yeah.
People say roommate when you're not sharing a room. You're sharing you're sharing a flat. Therefore, you're a fucking flatmate. There you go. Constance says on se chat. Right. Yes.
Exactly.
I love it. Okay. Have you got one more?
Right.
Got one more. Don't spoil it. Let the people guess. I know it's a bit weird. Hold on. Where's my text box? There it is. Bang. Get on it.
Okay, good. I press
yeah,
enter.
Yeah, is that it? That's great. No, yeah. It's good. Okay. Je wanda sur toi.
Uh-huh.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen in the chat, Cameroon expression.
Oh, I said another
Cameroonian
one.
Expression. Yeah. Je wanda sur toi.
Mm-hmm.
Je wanda sur toi. Let's respond to the previous comments. And it's an apartment, mate. No, it's apartment is American. Do we have an apartment? Oh my God, the apartment? It's a flat. It's a fucking flat, okay? It's just me being my English. I've had two ciders now.
You're just like defending to the death, like.
Yeah, exactly. Right,
attends,
here are.
I like you, je te kiffe, je t'aime bien.
Attends, laisse-moi les mettre ça à l'écran. Laisse-moi. Mm-hmm. T'es trop toqué, toi. Mm. I wonder. So, je wanda sur toi is maybe I wonder. Wah, 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 wonder. Sur toi.
Not exactly.
Je flash sur toi, je t'aime bien, je te kiffe. No. Non, c'est pas ça, parce que I thought that was that. Je wanda sur toi. For me, it was like, je te kiffe. Like, I want, you're hot. I want a bit of that.
Like, you can also say, tu me wanda.
Tu me wanda.
Mm-hmm.
I fancy you, j'ai flashé sur toi, je te kiffe. Je me pose des questions sur toi. I piss.
You're going nuts.
I piss on you to show dominance. Constance.
Yeah.
We like it. J'ai flashé, je te kiffe. J'ai le béguin pour toi. I don't know what that means. Je te kiffe. I wonder about you.
No, not
everyone's
really
thinking the same
yeah,
thing.
No.
I wonder about you. Je croche sur toi. C'est quoi en Cameroun quoi? Ouais, exactly.
Quoi?
It's a reference to this clip. I normally do a thing with my mate Rolly about Québécois. Right. Je suis amoureux d'un poisson parce que Wonder, a fish called Wonder. Yes, oh, Emeline.
Nice reference.
Je danse sur toi. Okay, right. Let us know, Fred. What is je
it's
wonder
like,
sur toi?
It's kind of like, okay, you say something to someone when it's like, it's more like I'm surprised about what you're doing.
I'm surprised about what you're doing.
It's like je wonder, like kind of like.
Oh, I'm wondering. Why I'm wondering about
it's,
you.
It's a negative thing, kind of.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Like, so Chimawanda is like...
tu me wonder, ça veut dire tu me surprends, tu me...
Yeah, exactement. Okay. Tu me, pas vraiment, not really like wondering, but kind of like, like low-key shocking. Like, you know, kind of like you...
Would you say, like, if one of your... If somebody that you knew, or like, let's say... a famous actor or a director that you really appreciate, it came up that there was like a Me Too thing that they had harassed women or whatever, you'd be like, oh, je wonder sur toi. Like, you'd be like, oh, dude, really?
Oh.
No?
Right.
No, that's
well,
not...
Yeah, kind of. I mean, it's... I think you would say something like harder than
that. Okay, you'd say harder than that. So this is kind more...
In a conversation, like, oh, like she... And, like, I don't know. And then he, like... Like he, okay, like whatever. Like he borrowed 10 euros from me, and I asked him for it, and I asked it back, and it was like, I don't think you gave me 10 euros ever. It's like, Jawanda, kind of like what, like what kind of like a bit like what the fuck, kind of you know, kind of like what that's like, it's I'm not a translator
Aigle de la
by trade.
Il faut
so
Wanda Vision.
Je me pose des questions sur toi. It's not too bad.
Okay, eclectic music. Je me pose des questions.
Yeah. Like, okay. It's like kind of like you. Yeah. You make. Yeah. It's more than I wonder about. It's like you make me wonder.
Okay, Tristan, you. What the fuck are you doing? I didn't know you would do this.
Yes. Yes. We're gonna. Yeah. Pretty much.
Loïc, it's a wonderful world. It is a wonderful.
What kind of like when I'm like oh like that's crazy like je wonder man. What? Like what?
That's cool. I like that.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. All right. Since we're on the expressions, should we do some proper British expressions?
Go ahead.
Let's get. Since Fred has got his very American accent, clearly he's been hanging around with
my very American accent.
I'm
ready.
You're fucking ready. He's been hanging out with too many Americans, in my opinion. So let's get him some proper British. Ladies and gentlemen, in the chat, whether you're on Twitch, whether you're on Facebook or YouTube.
Oh, wait, there's this one. Tu es dans le dem.
Tu es dans le
dem. I saw it earlier.
Is that from Cameroon?
Yeah, it's like things are not going well for you. It's kind of like...
Tu es dans le dem.
Yeah, tu es dans le dem.
All right.
Ooh, alors, ça en dem. Like, it didn't work.
Okay.
Like, c'est le dem. It's not good. It's not good at all.
What do they say in Maghreb? C'est la hesse.
C'est la hesse.
Is that the equivalent?
C'est la hesse.
All right, let's go.
Oh, c'est l'undem. C'est l'undem.
Favorite British English expressions for Fred right now in the chat. Let's go.
I need to spend a bit. That's a last straw. Yeah.
Last straw. You know what the last straw is. We need more British ones than that, Fred.
I need to spend a penny?
I don't know if that's a thing. Right, here we go. Olivia Chung. Let's go. Olivia Chung.
Barking up a wrong tree.
Go on.
Wait. I get it, but like, do you use it in the context of like you complain to the wrong person or you kind of like barking up the wrong tree or like
up the wrong tree?
You're like, you're taking interest in like maybe like in someone who doesn't like have interest back, you're like barking up the wrong tree.
I think it could be used in that context, like, oh, that girl, you're barking up the wrong tree, mate. She's not interested.
Yeah, it's like, let it go.
Yeah, or it can be used in like, I don't know, the first thing that came to mind was like a police investigation.
Yes, you know, exactly. Like, looking in the wrong spot.
Yeah, you're looking for evidence in the wrong... Yes. You're barking up the wrong... Yeah, it's too easy. All right, yeah, let's go.
I thought you need to spend a penny. Is that a thing?
No, I don't know. I don't know. If I don't know it, I'm not putting it out because otherwise it's too... Right, let's go. Adolfo Penna, you're flick the bean. To flick the bean. We've had this one on the show before with another guest.
Is it dirty?
Yes. Wow. Yeah, go on. What's your guess?
Flicking the bean, is it masturbation?
It is for women, yeah.
Yes, exactly. Like flicking the bean. Okay,
flicking the clitoris. The clitoris is like the shape of a bean. Is it?
Is it?
I don't
is
know.
It the bean?
Never seen have one
you,
in my life.
Adolfo, have you seen one? It doesn't look like a bean.
Hold on.
I've seen some, and I've also cooked
beans.
No,
but you're not choosing these because you know some of them.
Yeah, right. You choose them.
I saw one which was good. It's right. Mike Wheeler off of Facebook says it's the dogs. Mate, this side is the dogs.
Ooh. It's either like amazing or like shit. So wait. It's shit.
I'll give you the full phrase.
Okay.
Mate, this cider is the dog's bollocks.
So it's not great at all.
Bollocks, you know?
Yeah, I know bollocks.
What's bollocks?
Balls.
The balls. Yeah. So, mate, this cider's the dog's bollocks.
How can it be good? It's the dog's bollocks. Does it mean it's great?
It means it's fucking great, yeah.
Oh, yeah?
Mate, in England...
Was it invented by a dog bollock aficionado? Like, what's...
I don't know. Apparently in England, we love... Dog's bollocks.
Okay.
There aren't many left because we castrate them all like fucking cunts.
It's like rare and like special and also great when you put them in your mouth.
I think that might... When you put them in your mouth. I think that must be what it is. I think the fact that dogs don't have a lot of bollocks nowadays because we castrate them all. If something's amazing, it's rare. Oh, it's the dog's bollocks. Maybe.
Okay.
Thanks, Mike. It basically means, it's great. Yeah, it's dogs. Great. Oh, mate, that...
I wasn't sure.
That show... On Netflix, that's the dogs, mate.
Wait. J'ai une contrepétrie en anglais au cas où, c'est rare. Contrepétrie? Do you want an example?
Twister.
Yeah. Do you want an example?
Yeah, go on.
Salut Fred.
Salut Fred is a contrepétrie.
Yes, why? Because it's phallus red.
Phallus red.
Salut Fred, phallus red.
Phallus red. Ah, phallus red. Yeah, this is what we're not on contrepétrie. We'll get to the contrepéties in a minute. We need some.
Say it again. Say it again.
Contrepétrie.
Contrepétrie.
Shut up. Right. Let's go. Let's have some more. You're taking the piss. You know that, right?
Yeah.
You're making fun of somebody to take the piss out of someone.
You're taking the piss. I shouldn't do an English accent.
Hold on. I'm gonna find some some good ones. Okay, this might be good. Marina Cho off of YouTube. I'm chuffed to bits. Yes, we found one that he stumped.
I'm chuffed
to bits.
I'm very tired.
No, but now that you've said that, like, it could totally mean that, but it absolutely doesn't mean that.
I'm chuffed to bits. I don't know. Never heard it. Give it to me.
I'm chuffed to bits means I'm really happy.
I'm really happy?
Yeah, like I'm chuffed to bits about my show last week at Le Grand Aix.
Shout out!
I'm chuffed to bits that you're on the show. Chuffed? I don't know what chuffed actually means.
I'm chuffed. I never heard chuffed. Like, is that like British? Like English?
Yeah.
Okay.
But because I know you're going to know the American phrases, so that's why I asked for British.
I'm chuffed to bits. I'm very happy.
Yeah. I'm really happy. I'm chuffed to bits.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah.
That I never heard of that.
I don't know where chuffed comes from. Chuffed.
Okay. I'm chuffed to bits. Okay. I'm learning things. Okay.
Yeah. Je suis hyper content. That one you'll know. the ladies on the chat are saying, don't ever actually flick a clitoris, please.
Yeah, no.
We talked about flicking the bean.
Don't do that. Don't
flick the...
That's terrible. No, don't do that.
Just
that's...
be gentle.
Yeah.
Be consistent and be...
Just like listen to the person.
All right, let's go. The bee's knees. Marina Cho again.
It means like it's really, really great. She's very positive. That means it's really great. Yeah,
it's the bee's knees. It's the dog's bollocks.
Yeah. That's the bollock is equivalent
to
a bee's knee.
We take animal parts and we make them good. The dog's bollocks, the bee's knees.
The bee's knees.
The cow's tails.
The cow's tails?
Oh. No, I've just made that one up.
Yeah. The ostrich's neck.
Oh. Oh. Let's do one more.
What a chav.
Yeah, but that's not really an expression, but that is, all right. Okay, here we go. Robin Hope.
Sorry.
Wait, go on.
It's one I know, but you know it.
Adolfo.
A few sandwiches short of a picnic.
Oh, we've done this one before from Mamadou Ngate. A few sandwiches short of a picnic. You know that
It
one?
Means you're a bit nuts, you know?
I don't know if it means you're a bit nuts or it means you're stupid.
Oh, like, yeah, like you're missing like a few things in the brain. A few sandwiches short of a picnic.
That bloke over there, he's a couple of sandwiches short of a picnic.
Yeah, I think you're probably right. Okay, so...
Let's have a chin wag, Robin Hope.
Okay, let's have a chin wag.
Yeah, you're doing the movement.
I'm from wondering when... Let's have a chin wag.
I don't know what wag means, but chin is chin.
Wagging the tail...
Oh, to wag the tail.
Yeah.
Oh, maybe that's where it comes from.
You know, like Stephen Colbert's old segment, tip of the hat, wag Stephen Colbert, tip of the hat, wag of the finger.
No.
That's how I know the word wag because
you know the wag because of that.
Yeah. Mm. Old Stephen Colbert, whatever.
Well, when you're wagging your chin, what are you doing? What are you doing right now? Imagine your mouth is open and your tongue is moving.
Eating.
No. Let's have a chin wag.
My mouth is open and I'm wagging my chin.
What are you doing right now apart from that? We're talking.
It means to talk.
Yeah.
Oh, let's have a chin wag.
Let's have a chin wag.
Oh, because my chin is wagging I'm talking.
Now you're... Yeah, exactly. As you're talking, it means like, let's have a chat.
Oh, let's have a chin wag.
Let's have a chat. Let's have a chin wag.
Okay. This one is overly complicated.
It is a bit over.
You could say, let's have a chat. And it's like, let's have a lip opening. Like, what? Why is it so complicated?
Oh, Jesus. Let's talk about, let's talk about your contre-pétri.
Yeah.
Because I feel like we need to define for the non-French speakers, because it took me a long time to understand what a contre-pétri is. Mm. Contre-pétri.
Right.
So we have them in English where you take the first letter. Mm. It's two words. You take the first letter of one word, the first letter of the second word.
I
and you
how that's called recently.
You inverse it. You inverse it. Is that an English word? Inverse it.
Ah, damn.
You switch it.
Spooner. Yeah. Spooners in English.
Spoonerisms.
Spoonerism.
A spoonerism. Yeah. I don't know if that's the same thing. I think it might be the same thing.
It's kind of close.
Is it the same thing, internet?
It's kind of close.
Is that what we call it in English? A spoonerism in English. Ollie P.
Yeah.
Yes, it is. Okay. Spooners. So.
Pig lad? No.
a spoonerism. So I'll give you a typical example. Mm. In English. Oh, I said this the other day to my daughter and I've forgotten what it is now. Mm. Oh Christ! What was it? Not silly bugger. Give me a spoonerism in English, ladies and gentlemen. I need a spoonerism in English right now. Go in the chat.
Somebody save us.
Fuzzy. Fuck.
Park. No. Park hark doesn't mean anything.
Yeah, I mean park hark. It's like a car park. Yeah, it is. No, it is. Why are you laughing?
What's a cark? It needs to make sense.
Yeah, car park.
It needs to make sense.
Oh, both ways.
Both ways.
Oh, so in French it needs to make... Oh! Yeah.
Like, what, Luke, there's a very classic dirty one, which is like, je te laisse le choix dans la dette.
Okay.
It makes sense.
Yes, okay. Contre-pétri, English speakers, both words, when the first letter is switched... They need to make sense.
If I can get my phone, I have one right now. Can I get my phone? I take my phone.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. Whereas in English, they don't need to make sense. Okay.
Right,
here we go.
Shit.
No, sorry. Did you bang your head?
No. I didn't bang my head live.
Look. Okay, wait. So here's one. Here's one from Marina and Raquel. It's a bunny phone.
Yeah.
Funny bone.
Exactly.
So a bunny phone they both... Like
the phone, the shape of a bunny.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay, but wait, in English, Ollie P, this is a good one, a Carrie Hunt.
Oh, I forgot.
You're a Carey Hunt.
What's Carey though?
It isn't, but you just got to switch. You got to say you're Harry Cunt.
Yeah, you're a Carey Hunt. Sounds like Cary Grant. No, this one was French as well.
So sounds like Cary Grant. Fuzzy duck. A fuzzy duck. Ducky fuzz.
Listen to this. François a tué l'homme sur le coup, faisant preuve d'un véritable sang-froid.
Hold on, what?
François a tué l'homme sur le coup, faisant preuve d'un véritable sang-froid. François a sang-froid. Like you bookend with like François and sang-froid. François.
Yeah, but hold on. I thought it was just two phrases. So the whole phrase is a contre-coup.
Apparently. So if you want to, like, I'm on like a trivia league online where I have questions.
Here's an English one on Twitch.
Pheasant plucker.
A pheasant plucker.
That's nice. That's a nice one.
That's a
because
good
one. Pheasant plucker does make sense.
Yeah, you
people
pluck
have
pheasants.
Plucked pheasants.
Yeah,
and also
you're a pleasant fucker.
You're a pleasant fucker.
You're a pleasant fucker.
You're a fucking. Fucking pleather.
Oh, Jesus
pheasant
Christ.
Plucker.
So I don't know.
Piggy bitties.
I don't know whether.
Piggle bitties.
Belly jeans. Mamadou. Belly jeans. Yeah,
belly jeans is nice.
Belly jeans, yeah. Like jelly beans, right? Yeah, that makes sense. So, but in English, fuck, what's the one that I...
Oh, wait. That's a long one.
Where are you?
A circus is a cunning array of stunts.
and a hen do is. A circus is a stunning array of cunts.
And a hen do is.
And a Hindu is, but yeah. What's that?
So I think a circus is a cunning array of stunts.
Is a stunning array of... Okay. Jesus. There you go. That's a great
example.
That's
a good one. That's a good one.
Hold on. So your thing was... That was a long one.
Yeah.
François
a tué l'homme du premier coup faisant preuve d'un véritable sang-froid.
So then if you switch it around, it's sang-froid.
Et François.
So, but hold
that's
on. Read
why.
The sentence wait. In normal, non-contrepéd... Sang-froid a fait preuve...
No. François... a tué l'homme sur le coup.
Stop. Sang-froid a tué l'homme sur coup.
Sur le yeah. Faisant preuve d'un véritable...
D'un véritable François.
It doesn't make sense.
No, it doesn't.
Okay, so I guess spooner is not about making sense. It's about like the word switching. Whereas contrepétrie is like you usually... Like, salut Fred. It's like you say a normal sentence that makes sense. And then you then... Glisser dans la piscine...
Pisser dans la...
Glycine.
Glycine. Non, ooh. Ça fonctionne pas.
Glycine, I think.
Oh, maybe. Where did you see that? Where did you see that? Glisser dans la piscine, Sabine?
Glycine is... I think it's like... I don't know how dirty we're supposed to be in the show. Even though glycine is not dirty. It's just like the body.
what is glycine? I don't know what glycine is.
I don't know. Oh, it's a plant. Okay. I'm thinking of... What am I thinking of? Oh, I'm thinking of cyprine, which is different.
Cyprine?
Yeah. You can Google cyprine if you want. Glycine is a plant. Cyprine is not a plant. It's with an I. Why? We're just Googling stuff now.
Yeah, I was Googling. I was just checking something. Oh, there we go. A well-boiled icicle.
A well-boiled icicle. What? A bell?
No. A bell-oiled. A well-oiled bicycle.
Maybe. Oh.
But there's only one
it's
word.
Not dirty. I don't care.
Well, it might be. How well oiled is your bicycle?
That's also a good thing about contrepétrie. Usually they're dirty.
Right. So yours.
It's not
going
just
going back
a word
to your way. Name. So what was it? Fred. What?
Salut Fred.
Salut Fred.
Yeah.
Phallus red.
Phallus red.
Phallus red means
stiff.
A stiff
penis.
Stiff penis. Fucking hell.
Il court le fur. I like that. People are just sending us the radio. We're comedians. We're very simple. We're surprisingly simple about
anything
the type
makes
of,
us laugh.
We spend our days writing elaborate jokes, and then people are like, "Je laisse le choix dans la tête." You're like, "Haha, that's so funny." I don't know. Okay, genuine thought I've had sometimes about comedy, which is. Do you think you'll ever write anything funnier than a fart?
Than a fart?
A fart can be devastating. Like, how funny it is. Like, a fart can be like, or someone falling. You know what I mean? Like I'm not sure many jokes.
It depends on the context, but yeah. Probably not. No, I don't think so.
We're trying to get there, but like...
Well, because you need to have the context of the thing. Like, one of the funny... You were speaking about farts. One of the funniest moments that my wife and I had recently. I say recently, it was like 2 years ago, is when the first time that our baby farted like an adult. Like a small thing like that. It was just like... And I looked at my wife. I was like, really? And she goes, it wasn't me, dickhead. It was her. And I literally was like, nah, there's no
way.
There's not enough space inside of that to make.
But the container is too small.
Yeah, but babies fart like adults. I talk about it in my stand-up show, in the recent one. Oh, but yeah, like it's just like that. So that was the one of the funniest moments. So I don't think, because I now talk about that on stage and it makes people laugh, but it was not as funny for them as it was for us when we were lying in bed.
Exactly.
And in the cot,
we're just trying to like
next to the bed, she farted, so.
Oh wait, the fart isn't trying to be funny. That's what makes it the funniest thing in the world. Oh, that's poetic.
That's deep shit. That's some deep
shit. The fart isn't trying to be funny. Thank you, Ines.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Nothing beats a contextual fart. Ollie P.
We're just out here trying to beat farts, and you know what? We're trying our best. We're trying our best, truly.
That's a good title for a stand-up show. Fred Eyangoh, underneath, like, with your photo, trying to be as good as a fart. Oh, Jesus.
Damn. Yeah.
You guys
are 12.
You guys are 12. Yeah. Sorry, life for my batteries. Yeah. Farts make us laugh. I don't know. I think they make... men laugh more than women. I don't know. We're childlike.
Yeah.
We're subhuman, subintelligent. Stupid shit makes us laugh. All right.
Yeah, it's true. It's true. Can't even hide it. Can't even hide it.
No, exactly.
I was hoping for a break.
Rachel Gray. I have an 8-year-old son. I was hoping for a break from fart jokes here. All right, let's get off the farts then.
We're channeling the 8-year-old within.
Oh, okay,
what,
Jesus.
What do you want to talk about?
I don't know. Should we do a speed round of questions?
Yeah, sure, go ahead.
Let's do a speed round, ladies and gentlemen. Speed round of questions.
Do you want a jingle? Speed round, faster questions. Speed round.
Wait, put your headphones on.
Okay.
I'm going to make you do that jingle, but with the actual jingle sound. Ready? This is what the jingle sounds like. Ready? Mm-hmm. Yes, I like it. Ladies and gentlemen, before we go, let's do a speed round of questions. Let's put 5 minutes on the clock. Twitch, Facebook, YouTube.
Yeah.
Quick questions. Yeah. Let's go. What are the questions that you want to know about Fred? Mm. What are the questions that you have for us in 5 minutes? I will let you ask the questions now. I'll get you're out of cider.
Yeah,
we need more cider. And ask your questions now. We'll go through them as quickly as possible.
I just have to answer?
Yeah, but hold on. I'm going to put them on the screen.
Okay.
Hold on, mate.
People are still talking about farts.
Hold on. Let's get... right, this is the side that we didn't like that much. And then for the Patreon part two, ladies and gentlemen... because this show is in two parts. It's on one part for free right now, right here on YouTube, Facebook, and Twitch. But part two...
Support artists.
...is exclusively on Patreon, .com. Let me bring it up. / Paul Taylor, which is basically a platform where artists can get paid for providing exclusive content. And the exclusive content every week is the second part of every Happy Hour Live. So not only... do you get access to this part two? You get access to all the other part twos that have happened on this channel. That's the idea of Patreon. Let me bring up the screen. Patreon is basically, you buy me beers. You basically buy me virtual beers. And the more beers you buy me, the more extra shit you get from me and from this channel. So head over to patreon.com/PaulTaylor for part two. But before we do part two... we got to get the questions done.
Yeah, let's go.
Let's put 5 minutes. Hold on. Let me start at the very beginning.
If you see farts, you went too far.
Hold on. Yeah. Farting is a funeral. Okay. Hold on. We went too far. Blah, blah. You guys are 12. Yes, let's go. Mm. And.
Okay,
shut up. Hold on. Wait. Five seconds. 5 minutes. Right. Let's do cheers. 5 minutes on the clock. Pow. Yeah,
let's go.
Cheers. Let's go. 5 minutes. Bang.
All right.
Okay. Culture shocks in France. Go.
One. The British are good.
That was it. The bread is so good. That was the first one.
Okay, okay.
People don't respect queues. Next one.
Yeah.
Hold on. The most painful experience ever.
Ever?
Oh my god, it's too long.
Getting a penicillin shot right into my butt.
Getting a what shot?
Penicillin.
Penicillin. Yeah.
Penicillin.
You put shot. The wrong emphasis on the wrong. Okay.
Yeah.
A penicillin shot in your ass.
Penicillin shot.
Worst experience for me. Ah, I don't know. I don't have an answer.
Ugh.
Sorry. Next question. Okay. What's the funniest French word you know?
I can't say it.
Go on, say it. Fucking say it.
No.
Say it.
No.
What do you mean no? Mine is couille because it's difficult to pronounce, and I like the ouille.
I can't say it.
Fred.
I'm getting in trouble.
People are gonna be angry at you.
Do you want the real one?
Yeah.
The real one. Okay. I have to preface. Like, this is like in the concept of a
joke. We haven't got time to preface. Hurry the fuck up. Go.
Juif.
Juif, okay. I can understand why. It's gonna be right. It's something to do with comedy. Right, how old are you, Fred?
I'm 30. Hesitated. I've been recently 30 for like a month. Yeah, I'm 30.
Oh, happy 30th birthday.
Thank you.
What date was your birthday?
27th of September.
Oh shit.
Yeah.
Happy birthday.
Thank you.
Mate. Thank you. Fucking 30. Yeah. How easy is it to travel out of France? Nick Jones, if you're traveling to Europe, very easy.
If you're illegal, it's fine.
if you're legal, it's fine. If you're traveling outside of Europe, a bit more complicated.
Yeah, a bit more.
Fred, Perrine in London, which city would you love to play in? Go.
Berlin.
Which city would I love to play in? Oh, I'd love to play in London, but in English.
Ooh.
For English people.
That's interesting.
Can you change glasses? Let's go.
Immediately. There we go.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I can't see shit now.
It's a bit intense.
What's Fred's favorite beer? I can't see anything now.
I like a Belgian kind of like sour beer. I don't know.
You know what we might have to do for the Patreon? Like, you know what we're going to do for the Patreon? Just behind you, which people can see behind your shoulder. Now, come closer. Just behind Fred's shoulder, my best friends for my birthday this month, bought me a beer, a refrigerating keg thing. So we're going to try that on Patreon.
Okay, okay.
Because we're going to run out of thing. Okay, Jean-Baptiste says Samuel Eto'o or Joel Embiid.
Samuel Eto'o. I don't really like basketball that much.
Okay, I don't know who these people are, but that's great. Bertrand, Fred, t'as déjà été en Côte d'Ivoire?
Non. J'ai jamais été nulle part en Afrique à part le Cameroun.
Okay. Where is May? She's at home in Canterbury. Favorite ice cream flavor? Helen S.
Vanilla.
Pistachio.
That was the second one.
Huh? That was the second one. Was it? Mm. Apparently there's a super chat. I missed the super chat. Oh shit, I didn't see somebody giving me money on super chat. Thank you so much.
Oh, thank you so much.
Oh, I don't know how to get
for
that.
For him.
Hold on, pause the money. I can't pause the timer. Oh, there it is. There's the super chat. France, 200 francs suisse.
Jesus Christ.
Arthur, mais t'es malade ou quoi? How many is 200 Swiss francs in euros?
Like 200 and like 30?
No, hold on.
I don't know.
Come on, Siri. Do your fucking job. I pay you. 231 euros?
I was so good. I was so good. I did 230.
What did you say?
230.
Arthur, mais t'es malade ou quoi? Arthur,
it's real money.
Dude.
Say thank you.
I'm playing the jingle. Hold on. The jingle.
Yeah, go ahead.
For you. Dude. Fuck.
Show me the money! Thanks very much for supporting the channel.
He likes you very much.
I don't know what to say.
You're
that's
flustered.
Fucking amazing.
You haven't said thank you yet.
I did say thank you. I said thank. Did I say thank you? No, I said you're mental.
Yeah, you said you're nuts.
Dude,
and
that's
what?
That's fucking insane. Thank you. That's. I mean, all right, cool. Well, at least the cider is.
I swear to God, you haven't said thank you.
I did. When you said say thank you, I said thank you. I said thank you in the jingle, Fred. The timer has started again.
Okay. Let's go.
Because a pineapple on pizza or not?
No.
Correct. we were going down. Yeah. There is a super chat. Okay. Okay, cool. Hold on. Favorite Cameroon singer, Olivia Chung?
Richard Bonnat.
I like it. Yeah. I don't know who that is, but we'll find him.
Super cool guy.
Kristen Kim says, and Rolly. Rolly is currently in an aeroplane back from Paris, back to Montreal. So he is not on the chat. Rolly, my Quebecois friend.
Yeah.
Yeah, he left this morning. I mean, he should be home, but he's not home. I guess he went to go see his girlfriend for a bit of a...
bin fleeking.
Did you... Michele, did you ever do a joke that went too far?
Too fart?
I didn't see it.
For sure. For sure. Like, I really think that if you don't, like, try things and, like, you know, cross the line a little bit, you won't really find what you're looking for. So, yeah, definitely. For sure. Yeah. Yeah. I'm not doing it again because I'm like, no. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. Both of us. Everyone. Every comedian has done a joke
that's
gone too far. But sometimes it's in a room full of 20 people. So,
those 20 people know about it. You get to, like, the big stages, you've already done that joke before. So, you don't need it. Okay. Let's go.
Exactly. Worst cliche about Swiss people?
They have the Nazi money.
They have the Nazi money.
Nazi gold.
The Nazi gold. Precise. Okay, that's a good worst cliche. I was gonna be like, they're too neutral. Oh God. Your favorite French food, Alexei.
Peut-être un millefeuille. J'ai mangé un millefeuille aujourd'hui qui était assez incroyable. Moi, je suis vraiment sucré. Donc
moi, j'aime beaucoup le sucré aussi.
Ouais.
Anything pâtisserie is amazing in France.
En vrai, un bon croissant, c'est incroyable.
I'll join you on that one. Couscous or choucroute?
Couscous.
Oh, it depends. Depends on the situation. Mm. I like both. Have you been back to Cameroon since you left?
Yeah, I've been back recently and I'm going back for Christmas. If you want to join me, Carlos Camejo.
Sasha says, I just joined. What did I miss? Fuck me, Sasha. You missed so much. Your worst phobia, Robin T. Let's go.
Like, you know when it's raining a lot and like water is like going down like the road and everything?
Like a river in the road when it's raining a lot.
Yeah, okay. That's super scary.
That's weird. My worst phobia is drowning, similar.
Yeah,
it's if I were to drown.
Water related. Yeah,
it's water related. Biggest crowd you've ever done, Web Disa?
Maybe like 120. I've never done like a big room like you.
Dude, I need to get you on some shows.
Please, go ahead.
My biggest room was last week.
Yeah, 2,400.
5 days ago. 2,500 people.
Fucking hell. That picture looked great right away.
Mate, it's because I got an iPhone, and the new ones are amazing. Trottinette ou vélo, Jeremy Edwards?
Oh, vélo, for the last like seven years.
You came on a bike.
I have a bike. My bike is named Gigi, Giancarlo Bianchi, for the full name.
Okay, I need to sort myself because I can't figure. Right, okay. Squid Game, Casa de Papel. I haven't seen Casa de Papel.
Neither.
So Squid Game.
Neither.
You've never seen neither.
No, I probably never. No,
dude. Squid Game, get on it.
No.
No, it's everyone's watching it. Blah blah. How did you guys meet? Comedy show.
Comedy show.
Favorite cheese.
Favorite cheese. I don't know. Like
cheddar. Just to piss you French people
like
off.
Like a good Cantal. I don't know. Yeah.
Pain au chocolat ou chocolatine?
Pain au chocolat. I wasn't born in France. I'm not part of that debate.
Correct answer. Écharpe ou foulard? For me, it's the same thing.
None. I don't wear anything.
No, nor do I, because
I get too hot and I lose them. They're made to be lost and I'm done.
Écharpe ou foulard for French people?
That question.
No one in England wears a fucking scarf. I don't know what the difference between écharpe ou foulard is.
I don't know either. I think if for the head, foulard, technically.
Foulard, maybe.
Yeah.
Fish and chips or Indian curry?
Ooh. Indian curry.
It depends. I like both.
Yeah.
It depends. Right, let's do one more. Okay. One more. You choose the last one.
Okay.
I'm going to scroll down slowly.
Okay. What? Oh, wait. Okay, that's... I don't know. But how long is... What? What's happening?
I'm late, but hello, guys. Come on, let's choose one.
Oh, being given no choice, which Paul's cheeks would you kiss? Show me.
I'll show you. So these are these two.
Yeah.
The other two cheeks.
Yeah. Are these two cheeks? Those ones for sure.
The bottom cheeks.
Yeah, I might as well have fun.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for your questions. The timer is up. It is 9:21 p.m. Ladies and gentlemen, part one of the show is done. Part two will start in a couple of minutes over on patreon.com/Paul Taylor. Again, it's a platform where we can get money and some cool stuff for providing exclusive content to you guys. Patreon is always more intimate. There's less people there.
They've moved like beasts to the ass.
They've moved like beasts to the ass. Exactly, yeah.
I'm in that video. I'm in the LaBeast video.
Fred is in LaBeast video.
I have a cameo in that video. Oh yeah.
The Patreons will watch the video in part two and we'll show you where Fred is.
Me being like...
For the people who are not joining us in part two, Fred, where can we find you? What's your favorite social media? Where do you...
Right now it's Instagram. I'm on Fred Me Up.
Sorry, yeah, I just fucked up the jingle. So Fred Me Up.
Wait, update it. Like, do this and like.
Oh yeah, we were gonna see how many. 534. We almost got you to. We almost got you to 600. Okay, not quite.
Thank you very much, people. That's really nice. I appreciate that.
Go find Fred on Instagram.
So yeah, I don't post a lot of things about comedy. I'm gonna try to do comedy, but like it's mostly like me singing and dancing and like being silly and my cat. I do share like things with like when I'm performing somewhere and stuff like that, for sure. And I'm also like always plug my chess.com.
Chess.com.
Yeah, because I play chess here and there.
Oh, how did we not talk about that? Hold on, hold on. What's your chess.com account?
It's Fred Me Up.
So Fred, hold on, how did you do? Fred was it chess.com/FredMeUp?
I think you have to go on chess.com and then like if you have like to like start a new game and you do like
It's Fred Me Up. There is an app and all sorts of things. Yeah. So Fred Me Up on chess.
If you type Fred Me Up,
if you like to play chess, Fred Me Up on chess.com.
Exactly.
Dude.
Also like chess.com and Light Chess, both. I play chess.
And what was the second one?
Light Chess. It's kind of the same thing.
Like, Light Chess?
Yeah. And chess. Like Light Chess.
Never heard of it.
Kind of like an open source chess thing.
Okay.
Yeah. So if you ever want to play chess, I'm kind of getting back into it right now. So I've been off.
Did you watch that Queen's Gambit show?
Not yet, but I really want to.
How do you play chess and not watch
the Queen's Gambit? Dude, life is busy. Life is busy.
Oh, life is busy.
What? All right.
Ladies and gentlemen, go follow Fred on Instagram to go see his stand-up shows in and around Paris.
Yeah,
I'm
performing tomorrow. I'm performing on Thursday in French. I'm usually performing like Saturday, Sunday is like Jardin Sauvage, New York Comedy Night with Sebastian Marx, who's, I guess these people know.
Some of them do.
The Comedy Lab, I'm going to be in Comedy Lab like next week, which is like at the Au Chat Noir. There's a lot of places. Look for English there's like an English Comedy in Paris Facebook group where you have like a summary, like a very
is
nice
that still
comedian.
An active thing, English Comedy in Paris.
And yeah, like a guy English like Terrence Wong, who's hosting the show tomorrow.
Yes.
Did like the website with like the dates and everything. And you can find all the gigs in English, and I'm gonna be on some of them. And also support comedy in English. I love these people, they're all great. And they're my buddies, so I'm always happy to like plug everything at the same time.
Plug it all, mate. Thank you so much for joining
part
one. Ladies and gentlemen, we will see you in part two. If you're not joining part two, then I will see you next week, Monday at 8 p.m. Now, next week, Monday, 8 p.m., I will be in Egypt, in Cairo, jumping out of an aeroplane. That will not be live, but I will either, depending on the internet connection in Egypt, there will either be a live or there will not be a live next Monday at 8 p.m. with potentially Verino, Greg Crozier and Karine Jolie, the world champions of skydiving. That's what's happening next Monday. I don't know whether there will be a live or not. If there is, I will see you next Monday. If there is not, I will see you the Monday afterwards. Patreon. Those of you who are on Patreon, we'll see you in 5 minutes. Also, Patreon, we'll do our exclusive live, just me and you guys, on Thursday this week. That's it.
Shaking my microphone.
Yeah. Fred, give us an outro. Give us an outro phrase, and I will play the outro jingle, which is Command 9. I'm waiting for it, Fred. A good outro phrase.
See you in hell.
Thanks for for watching Paul Taylor's Happy Hour Live. See you dickhead soon for another episode.